Golovkin, who will be next? Okay, look, before we talk about the next potential, okay, nothing is guaranteed right now, but the next potential opponent, I want to say thank you. You know, channel's growing. I think we just hit like 6,000 subs and I don't know, 2 or 3 million views and a lot of activity, a lot of new members. I mean, we're getting like 100 new subs today. So, you know, thank you. I do appreciate it. I really do. I mean, it means a lot. You know, think about this. Give me your ear for 30 seconds, okay? I don't pander for stuff. When have you ever heard me, beg people to, subscribe to the channel or turn on your little notification or donate to Patreon or whatever the hell it is, or, you know, Super Chat or this or that, or, you know, never, you know, I don't think I've ever come on here and said that. So it's been organic, natural. And, you know, thank you. I just want to say, you know, just basically tell you guys that, I appreciate it. So, but okay, Gennady Golovkin. Now you're looking at a picture on the right, Mr. Triple G Gennady Golovkin right here, over here. Gilberto Ramirez, 168. Now, it doesn't make any kind of sense to me for him to move up a division and then come back down and what, fight Canelo in September or Billy Joe Saunders in September? I mean, what is the point in that? You know, and if they do that, then it might tell me maybe they're having, you know, trouble making middleweight. But I don't understand, because we know Gennady Golovkin walks around, you know, around 170, and he enters the ring around 170. So I don't really think he's ever had a lot of trouble cutting weight. So the whole situation doesn't make sense. And you got Bob Arum on Twitter, you know, basically tweeting out that the fight is they're negotiating. Okay, they're in negotiations right now with Ramirez and Gennady Golovkin. Okay, now where do we go from here? Maybe talk a little bit of conspiracy theory. We can talk about Spike O'Sullivan here. 27-2. Okay, now this, look, we're gonna go over a few guys, but I think it's gonna be this dude right here. Okay, 27-2, 19 KOs, 1 KO knots. It's funny, I was watching Showtime about a month ago, and he was on there, and he was fighting this dude right here, Douglas, okay? And Douglas, now, he was a hot prospect on Showtime. You know, he had his mom in the crowd, you know, a fan favorite, you know, a local guy, you know, the community comes out to support him, you know, and he was going places, right? Well, you got O'Sullivan comes in and basically just puts a stop to that, right? I mean, it was, you know, personally, I felt bad for the dude, for Douglas, I did. I felt bad for him. He seemed like a good kid, you know, he was basically raised in poverty, things like that, and boxing was like his way out. But I think he'll move on to do big things in boxing, I believe. You know, he just had a bad night. And another thing I noticed about that fight was I noticed that O'Sullivan, he looked pretty big. You know, he looked a lot bigger than Douglas. Okay, so now a little something you don't know about O'Sullivan, he is outside of a boxer, he's a stuntman. Okay, he was in the movie Strength and Honor 2007, The Last Round 2012, and The Vein within 2013. He's also tied to like some punk band in Ireland. So, you know, he's an Irish boxer, right? You know, and he's got this crazy looking mustache or whatever. So, you know, like I said, I'm watching this guy on Showtime and I'm like, who the hell is this dude? I mean, to be honest, up to that point, I'd heard of him a couple of times, but nothing major, nothing big. And now, you know, he's the talk of the town, right? Now, you know, he's the potential opponent for Gennady Golovkin. It's like, what the hell? Like, where'd this guy come from, you know? He just hit it big. Now, looking at his record right here, you know, anytime he's been in a big fight, he loses, okay? You know, Chris Eubanks Jr., boom, lost, okay? Billy Joe Saunders, lost, decision. You know, and you look at these guys here that he's fighting, you know, pretty weak opposition. You know, look at this, you know. You got Quigley, 15-2, okay? Now, before he went on Showtime and got that W, check this out, right? You know, last year, let's see, January, February, March, April, May. In May of 2017, he fights a guy with 2 losses and 4 wins, okay? You know, another guy, 5-17, 8-19. I mean, you can read, you can see it. So, you know, I think Gennady Golovkin is going to annihilate this dude, completely destroy him. So we'll see. But now, moving on to the conspiracy theory, and I'm going to get back to the, you know, a few other opponents that I think are, you know, we could potentially get. But I've got to address it. I can't not talk about it, okay? Mainly Canelo, but now you got Oscar De La Hoya, Eric Gomez, even Tattoo, the hype man, which is a friend of mine from Golden Boy Promotion. you know, taking the, you know, the position that Gennady Golovkin is running, and he wanted a way out of the fight, you know. So Eric Gomez right here, it sounds like he wants to try and find a way out of the fight. If that's what he wants, he should just say so. As far as Canelo, he didn't need motivation for the fight. You know, even Canelo, when he did his withdrawal in the conference, he went on to say that he believes that Gennady Golovkin, you know, he's afraid of him and blah, blah, blah. I mean, really, I mean, how low can you go? You know, it's like that little hula hoop game, or what's that game, that limbo, like how low can you go? You know, it says, right, just how low can you get, right? I mean, seriously, like, it's bad enough that you take clenbuterol, you lie about it, then you act like a victim, right? Now you're the victim, and Gennady Golovkin is the villain, you know, the guy that did absolutely nothing wrong, nothing whatsoever. You know, he's the bad guy, but now you're going to blame him? Back up. Okay. So you take clenbuterol, you test positive, you ruin everything for everybody, and you're going to blame the other guy. And you're going to accuse him of, you know, sabotaging the fight and being afraid of you. I mean, seriously. I mean, the only thing Canelo could do in my eyes is, like, kick a puppy across a boxing ring, right? I mean, seriously. Like, that's you just can't get any lower than this. It doesn't get any lower. You know, and I'm really ashamed of these guys. And they need to find, you know, some kind of, like, moral ground here. You know, I don't know who is their PR person, or who you know, negotiates that for them, or who's in charge, who's in control, whatever. But somebody needs to step in and say, look, you know, we're looking like some major dicks up in here. Like, we might want to change our strategy. You know, someone needs to step in and let them know, you know, because it's not a good look. It is not a good look, okay? But now let's look at the other opponents here. Where are we at? Boom, right here. Okay, you know, Dimitri Andrade, of course. Andrade, look, weak resume. You know, other than the hardcores, who is aware of Andrade? Dimitri Andrade, not many people, right? Not many people. So, you know, we're not even going to talk about him. Okay, now, of course, we just talked about Ramirez, possibility. Okay, Daniel Jacobs rematch. I wouldn't mind seeing that. Now, look, if I had my pick, it'd be a rematch between Jacobs or Charlo right here. Like I tell you guys, the future of the middleweight division, Charlo, because he is. I'm telling you guys, when Gennady Golovkin, when his reign is over, watch. I'll tell you what's going to happen. Canelo's going to run from the middleweight division. Who knows what he'll do? Another catchweight. Maybe he'll move back down, or he's going to duck Charlo for 2 or 3 years and have another mega fight, that kind of thing, whatever. But I'm telling you now, Charlo will take over in the middleweight division. He's a little green, okay? The fundamental, he's a little green right now, and, you know, he's got to get that temper in check. You know, that attitude problem in check. You know, he's got to get his emotions under control, because right now, I believe that is his worst enemy, okay? And you guys know I'm cool with Charlo, okay? He's right here, you know, he trains right by my house, okay? I know him personally. Now, let's go back and look at O'Sullivan. Like I said, I think it's going to be O'Sullivan. To me, it's easy pickings, right? You know, I'll say it, it's a cherry pick, right? I mean, it is a cherry pick, but it's a justified cherry pick. Now, But let me, you know, when I say that, I don't like saying that, because I want to say, well, you know what, Gennady Golovkin, he's a warrior, right? He can get in there with anybody, anytime, any day. And, you know, maybe he should. You know, maybe he should just roll the dice and get in there with you know, like a Billy Joe Saunders. Now, I understand, you know, Frank Warren, he's saying that look, I'm getting all kinds of mixed messages out of Frank Warren, Billy Joe Saunders' promoter. You know, he's saying, yeah, we want the fight, but we need more time, or we can't take it now, but we can. Yes, we can. No, we can't. Like, I don't know. I mean, every day I wake up and it's something new, but regardless, I mean, why not? You know, why not, right? I mean, to me, I think Gennady Golovkin can beat both of them, Canelo and Billy Joe Saunders. So, but we'll see. Now, the weird thing about this O'Sullivan dude, right, is I read an article where he was negotiating with Canelo for a potential September matchup. I'm like, what? Like, really? That doesn't make any sense. Like, you know, I mean, there's so much going on right now, you know, that it just doesn't, a lot of it doesn't add up. You know, with the whole Canelo thing, right? Let me go, like I said, I'm going to go Alex Jones on you for a minute. You know, we're going to go the moon landing was fake, you know, flat earther on you for a minute. And I kind of think, and I'm going to make a whole, you know, separate video about it, but I kind of think that maybe, just maybe, well, maybe a little more than maybe, Golden Boy planned the whole thing. Boom, drop the mic. I said it. Unsubscribe, whatever. Right? I said it. I'm beginning to think that Golden Boy wanted a way out of the fight, right? You know, whenever Canelo started blaming Gennady Golovkin, or not blaming, but accusing him of wanting out of the fight, you know, because he was afraid to lose or whatever, I'm thinking in my mind, well, wait a minute. No, you know, you, that's you. You are. You know what I mean? It's like when you're a little kid and you call people what you are. You know what I mean? It's just like this psychology 101, right? I'm sitting here thinking like, well, that's odd. You know, so I started thinking about it. And what better way? If you're a promoter, what, I mean, really, could you think of a better way? You know, we're going to have our dude test positive for, you know, PEDs, but, he's going to be the victim. It's contaminated beef. You know, poor Canelo. Gennady Golovkin, he's the villain. But, you know, now we're out of the fight, right? You know, so I'm beginning to think, I mean, call me crazy, whatever, I don't care. I'm beginning to think that Golden Boy came up with the whole damn thing. You know, it's a thought. But, and I'm going to get in deep to it. And look, I've got a good video coming out about it. You know, I've done a lot of research. And actually, I need to give credit to another video. I watched a video a couple days ago. And man, this guy broke it down. I mean, he broke down dates and times and, you know, different things that I've never even heard about. You know, like just breaking, you know, not say breaking news, but, you know, like undercover news. So, you know, I'm going to make a whole video about that that kind of adds a little bit of, I don't know, a little bit of proof to what I'm talking about. So, but anyway, yeah, right here, let's go over it. Demetrius Andrade, and Gilberto Ramirez, Daniel Jacobs, Charlo, and Spike O'Sullivan. Who do you want to see, right? Who do you want to see? I mean, I definitely, Gennady Golovkin, he's a fighter. You know, he's got to remain active. You know, he waited on the sideline during the Chavez. Remember on the Chavez fight, Oscar De La Hoya, he's like, oh, no. You can't fight. You can't fight. We can fight, but you can't. Okay, so they had Gennady Golovkin miss a payday. Now, think about how much money Golden Boy has cost Gennady Golovkin. You know, he had to wait on the sideline. Instead of going after Billy Joe Saunders, he had to wait during the Chavez fight. Now he's missing out on the biggest payday of his career, right? It's crazy. I mean, they have, you know, look, if I'm Gennady Golovkin's manager, I would just say forget the whole Canelo thing. You know, as much as that just crushes me because I wanted that rematch. I mean, personally, I wanted that rematch more than I think I've wanted any matchup in current boxing history. More than I wanted Mayweather Pacquiao. More than I wanted, you know, a Thurman Brook or whatever, you know. I wanted the rematch. I wanted justification, clarification, things like that. So anyway, leave it below. Who do you want to see? What do you think?